there. I'm Green Deane.
Welcome back to my 10th video here on EatTheWeeds.com. Today we're going to talk about Rumex, large genus with about 200 species. I'm sure there's one near you, but they vary greatly in size, so in shape, so you have to find out which one's near you. There are several here in Central Florida, and I'm going to be talking today about an early season one, one that I happen to like because it's always rather mild, pretty easy to identify, and unlike other ones, it doesn't go into the season, doesn't get ranked too much. And now, as far as Rumex goes, you know, humanity has been involved with them for a long time. Rumex is an old Roman term for the same plant. Of course, they stole it from the Greeks, but I've been nibbling this plant for, I hate to admit it, but 50 years. Did you say 50 years? More than 50 years. Used to call it sorrel grass when I was a kid. Same shape, same plant. Same shape. May not have been the same plant, but the same shape. In fact, it was probably the other one I mentioned in the video. And it's a plant that you can eat in moderation because it has oxalic acid. Now, it's interesting that commercial plants have oxalic acid in them, and nobody ever has to warn people, but with the wild plants with oxalic acid, we warn people that it has that. So you can eat a little of it on the trail, you can throw it in salads, or you can make a soup out of it because cooking tends to reduce the problem of oxalic acid. So let's take a little videos that I took. Now, I took these videos while I was out biking. I take my camera and I take my video, I take my still camera, my video camera, and if I see something that I can use, improve a picture or do something on for you, then I take them. So that's where they were taken. So let's go take a look at those, and we'll be right back to talk about itemizing.
Variety of Rumex or sorrel. And here we have one in the springtime in Central Florida. You can notice the lanceolate leaves. Very, very pretty. Also veins that are not parallel but run towards the end of the plant. Lovely. It's a nice tart flavor. Matter of fact, I've even sampled this leaf, as you can tell. As we come up, notice it's got the floor seed pods up here. It's a very nice example of a lovely sorrel in the early spring. This is late February in Central Florida. And we'll just try a little piece here again. Oh, yeah. Quite nice. So there you have it. And actually, there's another one over here. We'll just walk over there for a second. And here you go. Here's another rosette, as you can see, of the Rumex. A very, very large one. And you notice the leaves. I'm trying to take a leaf off here. It's got here's a very classic shape. As you can see, we'll move up here. See that shape? Look at that. Very, very clear to understand. Almost like a blunt sword, a little hilt on it. Very tasty. I'll put that in my pocket for later. And lovely Rumex. And this one has not started this one's actually did start its stems, but they were sawed off. So on this bike trail. Across the a lot more Rumex. You can see here, nice lanceolate leaves, but we'll move along here. There's another patch of it right here. See how it starts out with the basal roots. Now this one's starting to sprout up some stalks to produce some seeds. And over here is another one. Look at these large leaves over here compared to what we just looked at a little while ago. Look at this. That's some good sized leaves. Didn't mean to move the camera around on you like that. Very nice, very tasty. Oops, got me a mosquito. Here it is, what, 23rd of February, being attacked by a mosquito. And a few more of them here. And another one over here. Here's three of them right here. Give you some idea of the rosette growth pattern. And a lovely one, some more over here. So it clearly has been seeding through here. Look at that, very nice. And when it ages, it turns pink, as you can see here. Look at that, a little pink one there. Let's take a look at the leaf of the Rumex that's very popular right here in Florida right now, the Hostatulus. Notice the leaf shape is very distinct. It's looks like a little sword, you know, with a hilt. And it's about, it's about 6 inches long. It's actually also slightly concaved. You can see it has a major rib that goes down the back. Flip it over, prominent veins that you can see. And I took several off the plants that were in that area that are on the video. So they vary in size, as you can see. Still the basic shape to the smaller one, bit of a curl to it, still. And we still get that particular shape, that lance type shape, which of course is what House the Tulips means. And one that was slightly curved, that's, I guess they would call that one a dagger, huh? So let's go back to the original. Very smooth, but you can feel the wrinkles. Classic shape. There's one other Rumex that has this particular shaped leaf, but it's also edible, so there's no particular problem with that. Now, there are Rumexes all across the United States, and they have a wide variety of leaf shapes. There's one called Crispus that's got a really huge, huge big leaf, and looks somewhat very different from this. So you need to check out which particular Rumex you have near you. Now, let's take also quickly a quick look at the fluorescence. Almost looks like grass in this camera, but it's actually little heart-shaped winged pods that turn into seeds, and as a matter of fact, they very often turn pink and red, quite distinctive to see. And surprisingly, this plant's in the buckwheat family, and very nice little fluorescent there. And you can tell, and this actually sticks up from the plant, from the rosette, usually 18 inches to 2 feet or more. And you'll see that if you go to eattheweeds.com, you'll see that some pictures that clearly show that. Very nice plant. And we'll put the classic leaf next to it. Give you an idea of what they look like.
Now, let me get comfortable here again. Just remember, I don't want to hit my pepper here. Remember, we itemize here on eattheweeds.com. First is identification. So we saw a definite leaf shape, a rosette, the bloom, and the bloom. The taste was tart, and of course, taste can be part of an ID as long as you spit it out if you have completely the wrong plant. As far as time of year, it's late February here in Central Florida, so it's exactly the right time of year. I saw them about a month ago, and they were coming into season, so this is the perfect time of year for them here. Environment. Well, Rumex, particularly this Rumex, likes dried, undisturbed ground. In other words, old pastures, fields, roadsides, things like that. You won't find it where they've been scraping the ground or anything of that nature. It likes clear meadows, things of that nature. Method of preparation. Small amounts raw. You can eat more of it cooked. Small amounts in salads. But if you want to cook it, you can eat more because cooking tends to leach out some of the oxalic acid and make it more, you can have more of it. I personally am not too convinced that oxalics is that bad for you, because if you can eat a piece of rhubarb, I think you can surely have a cup of oxalic soup. But if you want to know more about that, go to eattheweeds.com, click on archives, and when you do that, you'll come up with two indexes, an index of plants, and below that, an index of other things that are on the site. Go through the plants and you'll find Rumex and you'll find oxalics. They both have oxalic acid, and actually what applies to one will apply to the other, as long as you get them early in the season. Rumex is one of those delightful signs of spring, even here in Central Florida. And I hope you enjoy it. If not in soups, then as a trailside nibble. And until our next plant, and I'm Green Deane, I want you to think green, and I want you to eat green. Like this radish here. Ooh, bit of the spicy side. You know, radish greens, you can cook them just like mustard greens. We have to cook them a little longer, but they're still good. Toodles.